How do you do? Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. May Allah bless you all. I mean, brothers and sisters, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it the one who enabled us to meet in this blessed, beautiful masjid, to make it able for us to meet in Jannah with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Ameen. We make we able forget that this masjid, let him make a mark easy for we not to forget that, so he's in Jannah.
Ameen. And wallahi, it's very beautiful to see, alhamdulillah, beautiful Muslim brothers and sisters in this blessed village. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to assist you and aid you.
He said, fine, for me we see fine good Muslim delegates in this village. See, they ask Allah to help
me. And my advice is advice from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this blessed holy Quran.
He said, in advice what he gets, and the advice from the Almighty Allah inside his book and the Quran.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in a surah called Surah Wal Asr, he swears by the time. And it could be the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi, it could be the any time that we're in. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives an oath by the time.
Say the Almighty Allah, that surah when they call Surah Al Asr, Allah don't swear to the time. It can be saying a prophet in time or any time so far, but Allah don't swear to the time.
And this beautiful surah, I like to call it the keys of this life towards happiness.
The Sheikh say this surah when a surah to Asr, in like for column say na the key of happiness. Oye, an surah ni matela surah to Asr. Ono botol katela ni tiki an sapo. Ni pi anti kara sumu bone, kara sumu fino. Oye sinati kono yo botol katela surah nati.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to know, he can make an oath by any of his creation because he created them.
Say the Almighty Allah, he get right for swear to any of his creation, any of the things that we make, he get right for swear to them, because now he make them. Okoro bamari, you know you nukur kama bempa mom, komo bindi. Ate so mai, komo bempa.
But alhamdulillah. And as Allah's creation, us, we are only allowed to swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. And this teaches us from this beautiful surah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to link his servant, his abd, to him only and nobody else. And that's why, dear Muslim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another place in the Quran, and whoever relies upon Allah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient for him. وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Whoever depends on Allah, whoever links himself to Allah, asks from Allah alone. If you're ill, if you need shifa, if you have problem, if you have a test, if you have any difficulty in your rizq, in your provision, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is your way out from that problem. And sometimes, sadly, some people, they might accidentally, because of the tradition and the culture, they might call upon somebody that is righteous, somebody that is good, somebody in a grave or something, or a different idol or a tree or something like that. They think that the blessing comes from them, and that is wrong.
Or
And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said in the Quran, وَمَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Whoever fears Allah and only connects himself to Allah and he has taqwa in Allah, which is the highest level of the religion, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make a way out for him from all problems. And that is a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, the one who does not break a promise subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why then after that ayah he said, وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. And he will provide for him from means and ways he doesn't even know. He wakes up in the morning and he says, subhanallah, how did I get this? Rizq comes from him, a way, a job, a halal, something here. And he says, subhanallah, where did this come from? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this beautiful surah, Surah Al-Asr, after he swears by one of his creation, which is time, and he swears to show the importance of time, that every Muslim should take advantage of this time. And that's why, like for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swear like we swear, but that we mentioned the way of Allah is different. So Allah said, I swear by time, surely mankind is in great loss. Every human is great loss. If he do these things, he will be successful. You know, it's like when you say to your little child, your little boy, he did something naughty, and you say to him, wallahi, watch, I'm gonna hit you later. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying here, all mankind is a loss except illa man amana. So first and point number one is that you have to have iman and belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Illa alladhina amanu, those who believe. Number two, so key number one to have success is iman. Alladhina amanu, those who have iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Key number one to success. Number two, wa'amilu salihat, doing good deeds, good action. And wallahi, dear Muslim, this beautiful religion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us, it is easy, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ بِالْحَنِيفِيَّةِ السَّمْحَةِ. I have been sent with a beautiful, easy, straightforward religion. This religion is so easy that you might do little light actions, ibadah, small, but the great of it and the reward of it is so great that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you.
Muhammad afoy mate me ye ko nom ni jeo tay to lol ko no basic bay tay to lol tay ko fof lol ke fof o gala lol ni som o te mo put ni ira kere arra ma ni do ko kati afoy ni ko
إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات كي نمبتو وتواصوا بالحق to advise each other with truth. You see a Muslim make a mistake, you say to him, brother, Muslim sister, haram, no, against the sunnah, don't do this. We have to follow the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we stay to the truth, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَن يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. And the greatest foes, the greatest winning is Jannah. We ask Allah subhanahu Ta'ala to make it of his people.
Oh, you make a sask, come and sap, and then you need to talk to each other, come and send a cat at the final. A man send you. People need to be to the Kyoto at the final, a Marco, a Manco. People saw the Kyoto at the Missy, Tatira tank. The Bishop of Moko boost the Massibomati, when you kill a bike chair, the Bantic of Mansane. Name a big guy, Massap, or maybe a sap, Massi. Come on, man send me to go take a turn, take a bank to a name. Kato ko pai patas de to kera pai o te su mai ko ko ka ne su kan qur'an te ki uno ni ko no ben kan asun ta ko o ka ben to tan asun ta kera muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam o ni ka ti o ko kisi ki te ke kisi ko ali ko
وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. The fourth and the final ayah and the four and the final keys of happiness is that you have to have sabr, dear Muslim. Sabr is many. There is sabr on ta'a. You have to have sabr on ta'a. Meaning all the ibadat sometimes that we do, it is very hard. Like for example, you might live in a different village from these villages and you want to come and pray Salatul Dhuhr or Salatul Asr at that time of heat. You need to have sabr whilst you're coming here and the heat is on top of your head, because you're going to be rewarded for this salah. So you have to have sabr like we have sabr in the month of fasting. All day heat and hungry, but we fast so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can protect us from the hellfire.
On part toto ko si tiku mu yi tiku ta bi yo cho ko yi mai e ya mari abu o te mo ni da mo ni ke na mu yu ka yo e ko ta mu yu ba ni ni rei ka ma be ne te ma ka sali o so ta ti o muslimi o ti ko ba ka mu.
And therefore, the second type of sabr we need to have is sabr upon al-ma'siyah, meaning to stay away from all types of sins and haram, even if they are attractive to us. And finally, the third type of sabr that we need to have is sabr upon masaibul the aqdarul Allah al-mu'lima, the tests that come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes your qadr, as it's part of our belief, to believe in the qadr and to accept the qadr of Allah, the good of it and the bad of it.
Oh, you become sas, who got a tattaka muyo. Only pits come muyo at your poor poor grave. So long, the little, nay, you only pit no clear muyo or taco. And you need no name toy by only your papa malanaki, a tidy bear, tapping on Tadusu or muyo taco, a bank pipe, and any old kind of.
I will give you a couple of examples. I understood this type of point, which is the qadr of Allah. Sometimes it could be good or bad. Through my teacher, when he explained to me this example, I understood it more. Example number one is, for example, when you have medicine, does medicine taste nice? Or when you have injection, does it feel nice? No. But what is the point of medicine? Shifa with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Cure with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now it's painful, but later it is good.
Oshe ko ilu tourism ubal, o tourism ubal ane. Salata ka muhiri, ka ta etipi, fiti dene ka ngesime, te pro bunga opo lokri, kere te swampata hapo unipi. All the people who know what hospital. That was on going injection. I'm not going to say anything. What is it? What is it? Can I go to my passing with the mother and the Missasa? Going. Can't tell my passing injection. What is it? Can I get on catchy? A win. I am going to be more a cheerful for a career. Can't tell my son, but my son, but my book, the bin. Can't tell my son, but my dear, at a lady final. Can a man come to come back to my career? Only if it's a little bit of a shame.
A person, my teacher told me, a person in a country called Egypt, Misr, and he wanted Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless him with a child. And Allah did not bless him with a child for ages and ages and ages. So he was making dua, making dua, making dua. One day he got angry and he asked Allah, he said, "Oh Allah, why didn't you give me no child? I am good mu'min. I pray, I do salah, I do ibadah, everything. Allah, this is..." And he spoke to Allah in a way that is not correct. So he was asking Allah for something, but he was not patient about it. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him with a child.
Oh, tell me, oh, no, we're walking in the Otifa no go. Kuru emiwan. Chemotola, Chemotem. Oko ha, terrain, or sotaya. Temonobasa, Kuruko, your way. I go to the bench on my minimum study, minimum Uber Candina. Maybe she knew so everyone, Kuru ya. Oh, fourth of a tip, married me, come on your 40 kind of mouth. Kuruko, your quan.
But the story hasn't finished there.
Can you talk to me? More Kuruko, oh, I know you, we might.
Nah. The story carries on. When that child grew up, something serious happened. He became aq towards his parents and he became ashamed towards his family because he started being very bad to the extent that he started stealing. And this is a test because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted that person to be patient. He didn't want to give him that child because Allah knows his future and he knows his qadr, his plan, his destiny, that this child is not going to be bad for you. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the child, but he was naughty to test him. To next time, believe in the qadr of Allah. Don't argue with Allah.
Oh, yeah, ma'am. Oh, no way. Boy, put the carasadu kakas for him. I'm a to call the Russian call. So if I'm in faith, I'm telling you, I'm going to call the Russian call. I'm going to call the Russian call. I'm going to call the Russian call. I'm going to call the Russian call.
No. And then the final thing, my dear respected brothers and sisters, that I would like you to leave you with is what we can benefit from all of this is that if a person connects himself to Allah, he will be successful in everything that he does. And if he is always having patience in everything, then Allah promised him Jannah. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ, give good news to those who are patient.
Also, not for Kera, come a fino. Bones not. So, not for come a bonnet to give out for a good one is night, but fino man gentleman.
No. Aladina either Asabatu Musiba, the one if a calamity or test happened to them, they would say, Kalu inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi rajiun.
I've made him a little party. Come, you come up now for tomorrow. And if you take more time, come me, my dear, come up now. I'm for friends of Tellus.
This ayah, inna Allah, or this dua, inna Allah wa inna ilayhi raji'un, all of us here, we know it at one specific place. Where? When do we say inna Allah wa inna ilayhi raji'un? حالة الوفاة صح؟ نعم death only death a person brother dies sister إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون that's it but we don't understand his meaning Allah saying in the Quran any مصيبة you say إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون it means you're saying we are to Allah and we're gonna return to him it means no matter how big my مصيبة my problem is everything compared to Allah and his plan is small And that's why there was a woman from the Sahaba companion friend the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and her name was Ummu Salama. Memorize her name and memorize her story. She was married to a man called Abu Salama. And she had children from him and they lived a nice life and he looked after her and he did everything for her. And then with the qadr of Allah and his will and his plan, Allah, the Abu Salama passed away. And then she started crying and feeling sad. And this is natural, normal. When any problem happens, you cry, you feel sad, you're not happy. So she then saying, who's going to be better than Abu Salama? Who's going to be looking after me? I am widow now. Who's going to look after my children? And then she remembered a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if a calamity happened to you, and you say, Allahumma jurni fi musibati, O Allah, reward me in my calamity. Wakhlif li khayran minha, and give me something better than it. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Allahumma jurni fi musibati. واخلف لي خيرا منها إلا أخلفه الله خيرا منها The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said except Allah will give him something better She said this with full iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
And أبو قوي أم سلمة مولي ترى أدورني حديثني أنا سولم فوفكي أوفكي أولاني بين تجيبو ترامبو
Then lo and behold, the Prophet ﷺ came knocking on her door to ask for her hand in marriage, and the Prophet ﷺ married her. So therefore, when she said, who's going to be better husband than Abu Salama, the Prophet ﷺ, the best of mankind.
Abu Salama.
And that's why we learn from all of this that if a person, his heart is always to Allah and he has tawheed towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wallahi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open doors for him. And that's why, dear Muslim, tawheed is the key to Jannah. And shirk is a key to the hellfire, may Allah protect us. So therefore, always to remember to link yourself with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us anew from the people of Tawheed who die upon Tawheed and die upon La ilaha illallah. And look at this, the Prophet ﷺ said to as a last advice. And this is the last advice from me, as it was the last advice of the Prophet ﷺ. Man kana akhiru kalamihi la ilaha illallah dakhal al jannah. Iman in it and acting by it. May Allah give you success, and may Allah bless you, and may Allah open His doors of rahmah and shower you with mercy and rahmah and rizq, and bless you and your family and your children, and make you and your children from those who learn the Quran and understand it and act upon it, and to make our young children from those who are huffad of the Quran. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us and them. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to spread Islam and make us of those who act upon Islam and die upon Tawheed and Sunnah and die upon Quran and Sunnah and follow the guidance of Allah and His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wa assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
شيخ محمود
في حسن المسلم ما شاء الله may Allah increase your knowledge. That's good. Inshallah, say to them we'll bring حسن المسلم in English for them. That's the best book. It has all the authentic dua of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And every Muslim should have it with them in their pocket. If they can't read it themselves, get somebody to read it for you and to teach you. And from its name, it is called Hisn because it's a protection for the Muslim. It will protect you from harm. Small harm and major harm. They protect you from shirk, some of them. They protect you from the hellfire. And protects you from jinns. And shayateen. And that's why the Prophet, for example, he said, whoever says 10 times after salah, La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika la, lahul mulk wa lahul hamd, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir, he will be protected from different things. 10 ranks will be given to him in Jannah. He will be raised 10 ranks. 10 sins will be wiped off, and he will be protected from shaitan, and he will get the most reward that day out of all of the human, except if somebody does similar to him or more than him.
Okay, I want to respond for fake. Tell me what you want to
Also, the Prophet said, if a person walks outside his house, and he says the dua, in Bismillah, tawakkaltu ala Allah. Wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. I begin any action that I do of my day in the name of Allah. And I only rely upon Allah. And there is no might or power except with Allah. Allah will say to him, you have been protected, you have been guided, you have been saved. And then also the Prophet ﷺ, if a person walks outside his house and he looks towards up the heaven, and he says, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika an adil aw udal. Protect me, O Allah, from being misguided or misguiding another person. Aw azil aw uzal. Meaning, protect me from slipping. This dua is protect you from harm. You walk in the street and this, you will be protected with this dua. Any harm that there is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you with his permission with this dua. So therefore, these du'as that a person, for example, says when he's walking in the morning, he reads Ayatul Kursi after Salatul Fajr, he reads Qul Allah had Qul Adrab bin Nas, Qul Adrab Rabbil Falaq, then he's protected. And you say the same after Salatul Asr. Now then you will have protection for the whole day. And also, as it came in the guidance of the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, that a person has, for example, two angels with him, one at the right and one at the left, for the reason of writing his good deeds or his bad deeds. But there is also angels, one in front of you, one behind you, for your own protection, if you say the dua. And also the Prophet said, when a person goes to sleep, he needs to make wudu and say Bismillah and read قل Ayatul Kursi, قل والله قل عبد الناس قل عبد الفلق, and blow, and he wipes his whole body. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will assign an angel on top of his head to protect him and to make istighfar for him.
Okay.
And this is why if a person keeps the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his whole day, he will find difference, he will find happiness, he will find a different flavor in his own day, because he will be protected, he will be always with Allah, and he will be guided. الله أعلم. بارك الله فيك إن شاء الله. جزاك الله خير. بارك الله فيك. نصلي الآن أو مازال؟
أظن وقتي.
مازال؟
يمكن نصلي.
خلاص ممكن أن نعلمهم الوضوء؟
ممكن.
نحتاج. الداخل أو في الخارج؟
أظن أفضل الخارج.
خارج خلاص نعلمهم الوضوء إن شاء الله. وتطبيق عملي للوضوء وبعدين نصلي مع بعض.
وتو عنده. One of the Sheikh one will wala for we outside. No one see Abdul wala.
Okay.
Hmm? Who knows the one Sabu wala?
Allim him al-wudu, Sheikh. لا لا برا برا علم علم وخلي ما نتقاس ونتقاس احنا انت